Hello everybody, and welcome to the Organic Chemistry Lab Techniques series. This video is a quick overview of the general idea behind gas chromatography. For the details on how to use a gas chromatograph, please watch the video below. Gas chromatography is a separation technique. More specifically, it is a chromatographic technique, like thin layer chromatography, column chromatography, and many others. Like in all chromatographic techniques, the separation relies on your sample partitioning between a stationary phase and a mobile phase. In gas chromatography, the stationary phase is a high boiling point liquid which is bound to the inside wall of a very long capillary tube called the column. The mobile phase physically moves with respect to the stationary phase. In gas chromatography, the mobile phase is an inert gas that flows through the column. A gas chromatograph is essentially a temperature-controlled oven that contains the column. At the beginning of the column, there's an injector, where you inject your sample via a syringe, and at the end of the column, there's a detector that detects your peaks. Upstream of the injector, you have a tank of carrier gas, normally helium, that through a flow controller provides a steady stream of carrier gas through the whole system. When you inject your sample, it gets immediately vaporized in the hot injector, and the vapors travel down the column with the carrier gas until they reach the detector. When your compounds go through the detector, they generate a small electrical signal that gets fed into a computer to generate a plot, normally called gas chromatogram. The separation happens in the column, so let's cut out a short piece and look at it. If you make a cross-section, we see that the stationary phase is bound to the inner wall of the column and the carrier gas is flowing through it. When we inject the sample, it gets vaporized and enters the column. While in the column, each component is in equilibrium between two states. Vapor, where the molecules are in the mobile phase and are free to travel down the column, and liquid, where the molecules are bound to the stationary phase and stuck to the column wall. Gas chromatography separates according to boiling point. Here, the blue component has the lowest boiling point, that is, it is the most volatile, and the green component has the highest boiling point, that is, it's the least volatile. On average, the most volatile component will spend more time in the vapor phase, traveling, while the least volatile component will spend more time in the liquid phase, stuck to the column. As a result, the most volatile component will travel faster than the others and will be in front of the pack, followed by the medium volatility component, and finally the least volatile component, which is the slowest. As the compounds exit the column, the detector picks up the signal which is sent to the computer and plotted in the gas chromatogram. Your gas chromatogram is a plot that has arbitrary intensity on the y-axis and time on the x-axis. The two main pieces of information that you can obtain from a gas chromatograph are the retention time, which is the time it takes the compound to travel down the column. The retention time is analogous to the RF in TLC, and it is characteristic of a compound under the exact same experimental conditions. The second piece of information is the area under the peak, which is expressed in arbitrary units, and is proportional to the amount of compound that generated that peak. So you can use this data to calculate the percent composition of any given sample. Okay, I hope this was useful, and I'll see you in the lab.